In warehouses dotted around the outskirts of London, logistics giant UPS stored almost every movable item needed to stage the Summer Olympic Games. These pallets were loaded down with the temporary floors for basketball and gymnastics. Here, the crash mats for pole vault and high jump. And there is so much more.
We have something like 16,500 athletes' beds, for example, 4,283 whistles, 541 life jackets, 28 boats.
To move the estimated 30 million items, UPS says it's making 15,000 deliveries to and from the various Olympic venues, before and after the Games.
So these are practice hurdles, so you have to move equipment that isn't just what we see on the day of, but you also have to do the venues where they're practicing.
Absolutely, there's a whole number of training venues where we'll ship these hurdles into.
Yeah, go for it.
While some of these things are obvious, some aren't. I'll tell you in a bit what these small platforms are for. The logistics firm is also tasked with taking the athletes' 250,000 bags from airports or train stations to the Olympic Village and back after the Games. And during the Games, UPS will hand over valuable equipment to the athletes once they arrive in the venues, whether it's bikes, rifles, or the bows and arrows. It also has to bring the medals to each venue and take away drug samples each day, not to mention transforming venues during the Games.
In one particular example, we've got a matter of 15 hours to make that transition from one field of play floor to another. Very, very exacting timelines.
UPS will at least be given 60 hours to remove all the bits from the opening ceremony. But even that is not going to be as much of a challenge as taking everything away at the end of the Olympics and the Paralympics.
What has taken up to 9 months to get into all the venues, we effectively have 3 months to get out. And suddenly some of the temporary venues, which are being rented by the day by the organising committee, there's a lot of pressure to get out of those venues within days.
By the way, Alan Williams is sitting on some of the 3,000 bean bags that have gone into the athletes' rooms. Oh, and these platforms, they are thousands of bed extensions for taller athletes. And in exchange for all this effort, as an official commercial sponsor, UPS is in effect paying London 2012 for the privilege and gets bragging rights and the use of the 2012 logo in return. Jim Bolden, CNN, London.